What's up, everyone? Frank Wilkiria, welcome to the channel. Today I hope you're having a lovely day anywhere you are, because matters, yes. If you're healthy, if you woke up, if you can walk, if you can make your coffee, like me, let's sip this brew, and at the same time, let's go a little more classic. It's kind of weird to talk about classic, sort of new metal, when this thing to me feels like so fresh. I don't remember remembering this song. So, I'll try to make sense by listening, by sipping coffee, and we will find out. Evanescence, huh? Feet! More feet!
I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears. And if you have to leave, I wish that you would just leave. Your presence still lingers here, and it won't leave me alone. These wounds won't seem to heal. This pain.
Oh man, in a way, like, I'm laughing not because I think it's laughable, the fact that the song is so sad, okay? But because, you know, a little bit this sort of like new gothic, indulging into the morose, indulging into the darker thoughts, indulging into the longing and the suffering and the pain that becomes almost a little bit like glamorized, you know? Like almost a little fetish about talking of wounds and childhood fears, and I just want to be happy.
It's just too real. There's just too much that time cannot erase. When you cried, I'd wipe away all of your tears. When you'd scream,
I mean, it's, you know, like, I can understand why this song gets 700 million views. It's like, it's really like this simple melody with the piano and then the violins coming in. The melody of the voice is also kind of the way you're expected to go, so to speak. And of course, she has a lovely voice. So I'm sure also live, they're great performers. And it's funny because this, when it came out, I think the reason why I don't know this song is also because, you know, I was much more into heavier stuff, coming from grunge, hard rock, progressive rock, all the 70s and folk music. When I saw this new metal coming out, new metal, whatever you, still means new, okay? Now, when it came out, I was like, oh, okay, this is a little bit glamorized, you know, commercial. Riding on the fact that it's been so popular, hard rock and metal, that they're making it more palpable, they're making it more sellable also with the whole thing around. So this more kind of mixture of symphonic and harder sound. Even though here, so far it's like a pop song. So I wasn't getting too much into it. So I kind of skipped a lot of those bands right away. I started to get in more interested in new bands when artists like Bon Iver started to come out, and Ray LaMontagne, you know? Anyway, let's go.
You used to captivate me by your resonating light. Now I'm bound by the light.
Almost.
Your face, it haunts.
I wouldn't be surprised if this part was shot in Naples or in some Italian cities, because that looks like very recognizable to me, this type of environment. It could be also it could be also France. But that car she's on, it's a Fiat 600, very old car, also pretty cool. So it could be Italy.
This pain is just too real. There's just too much that time cannot erase.
It's nice the way that did this part of the chorus with all the voices coming in together.
When you cried, I wipe away all of your tears.
Go, finally we got all this build up, slowly getting into the bam feel with the drum and the heavier riff of the guitar. Otherwise it was a pop song, otherwise it was a Avril Lavigne song. Back to the same chorus, but again with the old band, okay. Very nice, this last part that goes higher, the piano, doing the same melody. I mean, again, like quite a lovely song. I can definitely understand why there is so much views on it. What is it? Wow, that must be one of their most successful songs. Their old channel has like 2.62 billion views, which it's a lot of views, but basically a third of those views are like one video. God damn it. Wow, on 50 videos. Impressive. Yeah, definitely a sort of modern classic of this nu metal. And it's interesting to see like also how it changes. You know, in the beginning this came across a little bit more commercial, and then now after 20 years almost, you listen to it with different ears a little bit, especially in the landscape of nowadays modern music. And of course there's so many elements that you recognize. You know, it's not that they're reinventing the wheel here, not at all. Actually, I think if you get a musicologist to analyze the progression of the song, I think it's actually quite simple also. Especially the first part, just, you know, with the melody of the piano and the voice, and also when the band comes in. But it's the way you package it, you know. It's a song that easily gets you into that kind of mood, and I can see why over time it's growing, and it keeps growing, you know. You really managed to nail those sort of like almost classical melodies with the voice, you know? And there's every artist, well, not every artist, but when the artist, they sort of manage to hit those peculiar, like a melody with the voice or the riffs, you know, that they just stay like a little bit like Iris from Goo Goo Dolls, you know, like there are certain things you're just bum, you hit it one time, and could be also double-edged sword sometimes, you know, because you get only that one song. But in this case, I don't think it's the case. But yeah, wow, you managed to create a hit that has a very long life. Considering that also nu metal or metal, whatever, doesn't have has never had the same type of exposure that the commercial songs or like commercial artists, more visible artists, they had already through the 2020s, you know, 2000s, and later. You know, it's always been out of the mainstream, you know, relegated to specific radios. Or sometimes, you know, never shown everywhere like you have for hip hop or R&B or pop music in general. So it's pretty remarkable that it grew almost to 1 billion. Anyway, guys, if you want to see more Evanescence, let me know. Today we're going to do more international. So, ciao. I'll see you later. Go subscribe. It's free. Yes.